Mistakes and errors in minimal access surgery. Human is made for committing mistakes. Mistake and error is an integral part of the human behavior. As a human, you can never guarantee that any task will be without any error. Even simple walking, we do mistake, and our foot fall in the wrong place. Even during the climbing the stair, even during eating, sometime we bite our tongue. What is this? This is a mistake. So, any mistake which we do, it has two outcomes. Either there will be few consequences or it will be without consequences. If it is without consequences, it is called as near misses. Just like suppose you are driving a car and for a fraction of a second you were sleeping, suddenly you awake and you will see, oh my god, nothing happened, I was saved by the God. That is called as near misses. 90% of the time when we do mistake, we do not get punished, we are safe. But 10% of the time there will be consequences, and in that consequences, 90% of the time there is only complication. And among all the errors, 1% is catastrophe. Like you were driving the car, 90% nothing happened, 10% time you will hit some of the other car, you will break your light, you will break your indicator. And if it is someone got killed, that is catastrophe. Exactly same way Arthur L. Bloomfield has told that there are some patients whom we cannot help, but there are none whom we cannot harm. It is very true in laparoscopy. If you want to become a reliable surgeon, you have to embrace the HRA. HRA is a new concept which has been implemented into the healthcare. In all the developed country, HRA is already applicable. If you will put the HRA in healthcare, HRA stands for Human Reliability Analysis. So, you will get in UK, there is a UK MHRA, Reliability Analysis, Human Reliability Analysis in healthcare, and especially in laparoscopy also, if you will put, it has been accepted by the HRA, that is Human Reliability Analysis. In United Kingdom, in most of the tertiary hospital where laparoscopy is being performed, and a team of HRA comes and they inspect that you are reliable or not. HRA is applicable in all high risk industry, aviation industry. There is no scope of human error. If you will do one mistake, life of hundreds of people is on a stack. If nuclear industry, one human error, millions of people may die. Satellite industry, once upon a time you heard that a Skylab was going into the universe, it started coming back, it could not reach to the universe. And the whole world was panicked that where it will fall, nobody knows. It is very dangerous. Cloning industry, this is also under HRA, Human Reliability Analysis. Cloning is a dangerous industry, we never know. Cloning, already you know that cloning, it is possible to make a clone of a human. And we never know on any unknown island, any of the mad scientists might be making a human clone. And by little engineering, genetic engineering, he can produce a human clone which will be 500 times more in the IQ from us and 100 times more physical strength. And a day will come when the people will produce like that. When you have to produce your son, you will tell the cloning physician that I want this quality, and they will produce it. And it is very dangerous. If it will happen like that, a race of superhuman will form, and they will feel that we are inferior. They will use us as a pig to learn laparoscopy, because for them we are useless, inferior quality. So, this is a dangerous industry. But why minimal access surgery is under HRA? The reason being, data capture capacity is available. data capture is not possible in open surgery. If you put in a YouTube and you try the open cholecystectomy, there is hardly any video. Open cholecystectomy is being performed for last 100 years, then you will not get any video. And if you any video, if you will get it also outside, just like draping, cleaning and incision and outside little bit. It is impossible to record the entire open surgery cholecystectomy, because your hand itself is hiding. When you are playing with the cystic pedicle with your fingers, even sometimes surgeons, they do not see. They feel it with the tactile feedback and they introduce the Maryland, and retraction is done by the assistant, and then with both the fingers they pass the suture, because your pulp of the finger is your third eye. And you cannot record, even if you use head camera, and even if someone will produce the camera, it is not possible. But in laparoscopy, laparoscopy is a surgery on image. So, data capture is easy available. It is mandatory now by court of law that every surgeon who do laparoscopy, they have to record the video. And whenever any error happens, any mistake happens, this video has to be produced in front of the medical council or the court. And once the data capture is there, you can get your all the errors defined. If you see the newspaper or the different type of media, in India itself, every day 200 medico-legal cases is being performed, being lodged against the doctor. So, man moves court against the doctor. And these type of news, already some of you might have experienced these type of medico-legal cases. And if you have not, then in future you have to experience. It has been proposed that every surgeon, especially laparoscopic surgeon, in their lifetime, they have to face at least 3 to 5 medico-legal consequences minimum, if you are very good. If you are already doing a lot of mistakes, then it will be unlimited. Some of the surgeon, they have spent their valuable time and money fighting court against the doc. So, purpose of this presentation is that how to minimize these type of mistakes, because $1 million question is that you have to serve the community also, and you have to protect yourself also. So, serving to other and protecting yourself is a very challenging work. There is no any profession which is that much accountable as our profession. Other professions, suppose a scientist is making a satellite, and satellite millions of dollars is spent in that, and they launch the satellite and it did not work, it get burned or it get spoiled, nobody is putting them in the jail. Nobody is putting a huge penalty for the scientist who has made this. But for our profession, accountability is a lot, and we have to protect ourselves. So, you have to understand how these mistakes happen and what is the cause of this human reliability analysis and going wrongly. So, we should do our own analysis, so that we can protect ourselves. There are 3 levels of the human error. One is a skill based level, another is rule based level, and third is knowledge based level. A skill based level means learning curve. Whenever we develop any skill, there is a learning curve, and learning curve is S shaped, it goes down, again rise, and again goes down. Initially, whenever you start any of the skill, initially it goes down, and it goes down, we feel like, will I be able to do it, can I perform laparoscopy, will I be a safe laparoscopic surgeon. That is a little negative attitude. Once you have got some success and your inertia is broken, initial inertia is broken, then there is a steep height, and you will start learning very fast. Within first 50 to 100 cases, your error will decrease up to 2 to 5% only, and after that, within 200 cases, it will become very less, 1 or 2. So, if you will do 100 tasks, 1 or 2% chances are that error will happen. After 200, you achieve a plateau, so that further learning of the skill is stopped, and then you go down like S. You go down means you are overconfident now. You are overconfident, and then you do, and some age factor also comes. So again, chances of mistake increases. So this is the learning curve, and learning curve everybody has to face your own. Remember, after this course you will feel sometime little more confused. Do you know, reason is that if you will learn more, then you have the more questions, and learning curve you have not achieved, then in those situation you have little apprehension, anxiety and confusion. So remember, learning curve, nobody can take your learning curve. Even your father and even our mother, anyone cannot take our learning curve. You have taken birth alone, you will die alone. When we die, nothing, nobody comes with us, and we have the learning curve alone. So this learning curve, immediately you should start after going from here, and you have to go rise your own. Nobody can hold your arm and stretch you to the peak of the learning curve. So initially, first 50 cases you have to be very careful, and then slowly once you will achieve the learning curve, after that automatically your all the problem will be solved. So this is a skill based level. Unfortunately, this you have to cross your own, and you have to develop your skill own. Then comes rule based level. Some of the mistake we do, even if we are very much learned, very much skilled, reason of being those type of mistake is we do not follow the rule, because we think that we are the best. This attitude we have to drop down. Just like a driver who is very skilled, but he is not obeying the rules, he is not obeying the traffic rules, then he is liable to do the mistakes. He will try to not respect the red light, he will try to overdrive the high speed, he will try to overtake someone else, he will not use the indicator and horns, and then he is liable to do the mistake. Exactly same way, sometimes we do not follow the principle of port position, principle of electrosurgery, principle of dissection techniques, principle of the pneumoperitoneum, and when then we land up in the complication, because we want to make our own rule. The rule is given by the seniors after vast experience. So we will make our own rule and we will not follow the guideline, then it is a problem. So you should must follow the guideline. And then knowledge based level. Knowledge based level means incorrect knowledge or incomplete knowledge. Nowadays knowledge is changing so fast that within 4 years knowledge is doubling. In 1980s, when our fathers were surgeons, at that time 20-year time was taking for any information to become double. So once you are completely knowledgeable person, your whole life you can enjoy. But now it is not possible. Even if we are completely trained, after 4 years we are old, expired, and we have to retrain ourselves. Because of Google and other information technology, the knowledge is spreading and developing very fast. So in those situation we have to take care that incorrect knowledge or incomplete knowledge should be avoided. And in those situation one of the bad contribution is Google. If you will see in the Google, Google helps sometime, but Google confuse many time. If you will see any keyword, then most of the time Google is searching the database which may not be very adequate. So you should must have the some access to the good database. I am giving you few of the important password. That is one password I am giving you to SAGES.org. That is Society of American Gastrointestinal Endosurgeon. Do you know, you are eligible to become a member of the SAGES after this course, because it is already endorsed by the SAGES, EAES, WALS and other issues. Only you have to take one certificate from us. I am giving you right now the temporary username and password which you can use before you get a member, and you can use and you can access the 4 journals free of cost, and so that your knowledge will be completely correct, and in that you will have the knowledge based level will not happen. So it is opening. By the time at the end of the course I will give you a password, a username and password which will allow you to full text access of the 4 best journals of the world which is dealing with. What you have to do, you have to go to the login, and login you will go, and after that you will put the username and password, and username password, you have to use the username contact@laparoscopyhospital.com. This is the username contact@laparoscopyhospital.com, and password is 1RAJNEESH. This is username and password. Yes, password I will write it here. This is username. This is username and password is 1RAJNEESH. This is password, and one you will put it this one. Yes, and you have to put this password, and when you will put this password, then you log in, and once you log in, you enter into the member area. This is the password, and once you put the password and username, after that you are in member area, and once you are in member area, then you will go to journal access. And once you go to journal access, there will be 4 journal, 1, 2, 3, 4 journals, which is on your fingertip, and then you click it here like surgical endoscopy. But you have to first come to the SAGES. You have to come to the SAGES. Due to the way Springer protects their website, you must start from this page. Then only you will get the 100% access of all the journals, and then you will have the complete access. You do not have only abstract, you have the full page. So, surgical endoscopy, annals of surgical oncology and journal of gastroenterology, and was in surgical endoscopy even the gynae, all the materials are available, and which can you can use for access. And that way you will be completely in touch with the media and the latest guidelines, and then your problem can be solved. You will be having the complete access. So, now this is surgical endoscopy. And you can see all are full articles. You can all full articles, no only abstract. And you can get all the previous issues also, and you can search any keyword and you can get the full access. Like suppose I am doing myomectomy, and suppose this is, and then search it, then see here all these myomectomy, Halifax method of myoma excision, and complete PDF. So, it is one of the best resources which you can have. A Springer, if you will try to go without your own, then one article they are selling for $40, $30, $50, one article. But here you have the access of thousands of articles and complete articles. So, this way you should try to get the knowledge, and knowledge should be always updated, because there is no substitute of the knowledge. In the laparoscopy especially, it is a so fastly changing technology, that what camera we are using, what energy sources we are using, after 6 months new concept, new energy sources, new technology comes, and we should must be. Those are not only index, those are the premier journals, those are index. Springer is the world largest index journal company publication, Springer. So, these PubMed and all, they are behind these Springers and all. If they will tell that you, I will not allow you to index, then PubMed will get ashamed that they are not allowing me to index. So, this is, don't worry, it is one of the highest quality. I will tell you about the surgical endoscopy, because you have asked, and one of the very important thing, and I am proud of that, is that I have many publication in the surgical endoscopy. And my professor is the chief editor of the surgical endoscopy. Surgical endoscopy is the, there are 10,752 articles related to, and available these are the in between 1987 it was started. So, it is one of the oldest, one of the first endoscopic journal, and it is the SAGES and EAES both is official journal, and Society of American Gastroenterological Surgeon and European Association of Endoscopic Surgeon, these are both. So, it is very much indexed, and there is no question of getting not indexed, and you can get everything which is everything which is available recent, and getting published in these journals are also very, very difficult because of the huge waiting list and the quality. If you will see the editors, peer review editors, all the pioneers of the laparoscopy in the world, they are in the editor board, editorial board, and the chief editor is Professor Sir Alfred Kasheri. So, anyway, it is opening, by the time we will continue. So, all the four are indexed, and then a skill based level, then a rule based level. Do you know SAGES is making all the guideline of the world, and it is SAGES official publication. Society of American Gastroenterological Surgeon, when they make a guideline, even the FDA has to follow it. Food and Drug Administration of the USA, they have to follow it, because once they made the guideline, it becomes rule. So, now these all the, now they are, these were the level of the our skill, that is our error, that is a skill based level, rule based level, and knowledge based level. Now, the categories of human error, there are two type of categories of human error. One is related to the performance of frontline operator, and another is latent hidden within the system. Who is frontline operator? You are frontline operator. If you will do something wrong, then immediately you know. Suppose we cut uterine artery, bleeding started, or we perforated the bowel and fecal matter started, then you will not hide it. You will not hide it, you will immediately take care. Either you will convert, or you will ask a surgeon, or you will call a urologist or vascular surgeon, and you will get it repaired, because you are responsible, you are afraid. This is not a big concern in laparoscopy. Major threat is that system is wrong. So, your system is not checked, and most of the complication happens due to the system failure. So, there is a checklist. If you do not want this system to get failed, you have to go for few of the checklist. Those checklist we have given into the laparoscopy hospital member area. The first checklist is there. I am just opening it, and I am showing you that you should get all these checklists printed. You should get it printed in and in A4 size. After going from here, download those checklists that is made by SAGES, that checklist, and print it in a printer in A4 size and give it to your nurse. And whenever you go to the laparoscopic operation theater, you ask for this checklist. We always are doing, and our staffs, they are trained to do their own. This checklist is called as safety checklist, and it is Aaron and SAGES who has given in their guidelines. Just like you see that when the you are going to the aircraft, and when the aircraft you come out from the aircraft, then aircraft engineers, they take over the plane. Even the pilots, they go, these air hostesses, they go, their job, this is not their job, but the aircraft engineer, a group of team of aircraft engineer comes, and everyone has a checklist. And the checklist, they have to check each and every safety parameters, even the oil, even the tire pressure, even in the passenger cabin, even the magazines which is kept in front of the seat, that also which magazine should be in front and which magazine should be behind, that also is written in the checklist. So, if you follow the checklist, 33% less error will be there. This checklist is downloading, and I will show you later once it is fully downloaded, and you have to use this to minimize. So, do you know why? In this checklist, everything is there. Check the valve, check the washer, check the insulation, check the vent, check the various little blockage, check the monitor, check the setting of the bean bag, check the height of the OT table, everything. And before you enter into the operation theater, your nurse has to do some every checklist, and it will be ticked and then signed by the nurse, and then it will be displayed on the board. If you will develop this habit, then most of the complication which is due to the technical errors will be corrected. even in that camera setting for that particular surgery is also written, and then you can check it and you can correct it, because it is a technologically dependent surgery. Just like when you are going for a long drive, your driver is checking the oil, checking the pressure, checking the mobile, that everything is fine or not, so that in the halfway I should not get a problem. Exactly same way this checklist is made. So this will take care of your system, and once your system is correct, then your most of the complication can be minimized, because sometimes we don't know and perforation happens because of insulation failure. We don't know, and because someone has changed the setting of the insufflator, it is getting a high pressure and we have the problem of insufflator. So this checklist will eliminate all these errors, and that way that is one of the category. If you want to become a reliable surgeon, you have to embrace three disciplines. One is ergonomics, another is psychology, and third is engineering. Ergonomics is the most important. Whatever we do the complication, it is due to ergonomics. Ergonomics means man interface between man and machine, and we are only interested to see the front of trolley. You should not do that. We should also see behind the trolley, that how the things are attached, how the cables are attached in the back. Some of the most important ergonomic already I have discussed, but some of the most important is OT table height. OT table height should must be compatible, so that it should handle of the instrument should be at the level of your elbow. So never ignore it once you enter into the operation theater. Then comes manipulation angle. That is also one of the very important factor. In contralateral it should be 60 degree, in ipsilateral it should be 30 degree. Then comes follow the rule of diamond, that already you know the baseball diamond concept, and there is no need of repeating it. Then elevation angle, that should be 15 to 30 degree. If it is more than 30 degree, you are struggling. If it is less than 30 degree, you are struggling. Then you to prevent losing the instrument. Sometime if we have lost the instrument, we are trying to find it by the heat and trial. You should not do that. What to do? Take the telescope panoramic, take the instrument panoramic, make the elevation angle of the instrument equal to the telescope, and go with the 30 degree azimuth angle. Automatically your instrument you will get it. So first you take the telescope out, then take the instrument out, and then go with the 30 degree azimuth angle and tip of the instrument, you will get it. Then we should try to get a coaxial alignment, means eye of the surgeon, target of dissection, and center of the monitor should be in the same axis. That is, more than 15 degree head tilt will decrease your performance from more than 25%. Then resting eye should see 10 to 20 degree down, because our normal oculomotor muscle is seeing down. We never see up. Suppose you are sleeping or you are unconscious, in those situations our eyeball goes down. So this is the resting. That is why in the cinema hall the expensive tickets are little above the level of the screen, so that resting eye is seeing down. If you will see it up, there will be a problem. Then your distance from the size of the monitor should be 5 times to the diagonal length. If monitor is 14 inch, you should stand 70 inch away. If it is 51 inch or 21 inch, then 105 inch away. Accordingly you will decide. Then ideally number of monitors should be 2, one for you, one for your assistant. If you have a 1, then keep it in such a way that there should not be more than 15 degree head tilt. Then OT light should be 20 lux. If it is too much brightened operation theater, you have a problem. Then avoid touching the bloody viscera with the tip of the telescope. You should try to prevent fogging also. There are different way of preventing the fogging. One is that you should keep the telescope warm. Another is you can use anti-fogging solution. So anti-fogging, thoda sa anti-fogging device lay out the plastic wala. There are some, or telescope bhi, anti-fogging solutions are available. There are some devices also to prevent fogging. I will show you one device which is made as a this flow shield. I will show you the name. That is one of the American company which is making a beautiful device to prevent fogging, and there will be no fogging after using this device, and it cleans the telescope itself also. It clean the telescope also. So this is important. Other way is betadine, sometime people are using, sometime clean peritoneal fluid also you can use. The best is warming it. Keep telescopes steady. Camera person should always take in mind that when he is showing the lower abdomen, then he should hold the telescope in the left hand, and hence seeing the upper abdomen, he should hold the telescope in the right hand. so that his arm will be by the side of the body. Suppose patient gynecologist is doing TLH and camera person is holding the camera in the right hand, he will have tremor, because as soon as your arm is abducted, your steadiness has gone. But if you will hold by the left hand, it will be steady. Do you know that is why the professional photographer, when they take a video camera, they always keep and hold it like that, if you see it very carefully, and they keep the camera on the shoulder and they hold it this way. Do you know what is the purpose? Purpose is that there should not be any jerky movement, because if there is jerky movement, there is eyeball degradation, and eyeball of the viewer started. So, eyeball of surgeon degrades this way, and eyeball, if it jerky movement, his performance and his judgment and his dexterity will be affected. Then keep panoramic when surgeon is ineffective. Sometimes the surgeon is not effective, he is changing the instrument, he is changing the telescope, he is tying a knot outside, or he is waiting for any instrument. At that time, camera person should keep panoramic view, so that he can see all the instrument together. This is the instrument that is called as flow seal, and it has a tube here. This is a simple plastic tube, and you have to put this telescope inside that. Telescope will go inside this plastic tube. ये कौन सा टेलीस्कोप है?
मैक्सवेल.
नहीं मैक्सवेल नहीं, ये लेके आओ स्ट्राइकर. दिस इज अवेलेबल. दे विल आस्क यू, वंस यू विल बाय द फ्लो सील, दे विल आस्क यू दैट व्हिच कंपनी टेलीस्कोप यू हैव, बिकॉज दे मेक इट फॉर एवरी कंपनी टेलीस्कोप सेपरेटली. सो ही इज ब्रिंगिंग द स्ट्राइकर, आई विल शो यू. नाउ वी शुड कीप पैनोरामिक व्हेन सर्जन इज इनएक्टिव. नाउ मिरर इमेज शुड मस्ट बी अवॉइडेड, मीन्स विजन एक्सिस and action axis should never be go opposite to each other. This is blunder, this is not excusable. Mirror image, as I already you have tried to practice it by the mirror image, you were not able to catch the ABCD spontaneously. That was mirror image. Here I will show you one example of the mirror image. Sectorization is good, but not less than 30 degree. Mirror image, see here, this is a video. In this video, this is a simple appendicectomy. There is a cecum and there is a ileocolic artery. Ileocolic artery, this is the small intestine, and this is cecum, this is ileocolic junction, and there is a band of ileocolic artery, and surgeon is trying to cut this band, and he is using one of the best instrument of vessel sealer, that is LigaSure. A LigaSure, and he is cooking it by the LigaSure, and it is very good. It will get cooked very nicely and cut, because LigaSure can seal the vessel up to 7 millimeter, and here it is very less than 7 millimeter. And he is trying to get it, and now the C bleeding has started, and there is excessive bleeding, he is not able to catch it, and it is bleeding, and then ultimately entire abdomen is filled with the blood, and he could not control it, and still it is bleeding, and he could not control it. Do you know the reason why he could not control it? Because his port was wrong. Do you know, if the bleeder you are seeing already bleeding, then it is easy to control. Because if it is bleeding, you go and catch it by the grasper. But if you see very carefully, in the beginning of this surgery, his telescope is in the umbilicus, one port in the left iliac fossa, another port in right iliac fossa. So this instrument is mirror image, and if it is mirror image, he is lost, and he cannot find out even the tip of the instrument to reach to the vessel, even tip of the. Another problem is he is swatting. So, ports are absolutely wrong, and he is swatting. Can you see the swatting here? This is swatting. Another mistake is, he is giving traction. Do you know, not only he is swatting, now he will catch the tissue. I told you during the electrosurgical dissection, that if you want to seal any of the vessel, any traction must be avoided. And if you want to cut it, traction should be given. So, he is giving the traction, that is why it is cut. And this is not the mistake of the machine, this is the mistake of the man behind the machine, who has not done a proper use of the machine, and that is why that much bleeding is there. So, it is very important, and which we have to keep in mind, and in those situations it will be decided. So, now it is bleeding going on. See here, this is the telescope, you have to put it, and there is one small connector, and this connector you will attach it here, that is all, and this will go to the insufflator. This tubing goes to the insufflator here. This will go to the insufflator, and so insufflator tubing you will not attach to the cannula. Insufflator tubing will attach into that, and then the tip of that air is discharged at the tip of the telescope. So, if any dirt is there, it will be washed out. Just like your windshield of the car, it has a flow and it has a wiper to clean it. This instrument behaves the same way, like your windshield of the car. And after that, there will be no any this fogging. Pardon? No, no, actually it is 10 mm telescope. So, most of the disposables are actually 12 millimeter, isn't it? Most of the disposable cameras are 12 millimeter. If you are using this, then you are not so much poor. So, you will use the disposable cannula, isn't it? If you, because it is, this is also disposable. So, if you are using it, then you are not supposed to use the metal cannulas. So, anyway, it is, you can try, but generally due to cost is $100 for one set, and every time $100 you have to open, because it is not autoclavable, it is plastic. So, ideally disposable, and disposable means all the other instruments are also disposable. So, anyway, so this has to be taken care of and you should keep in mind. Distance between the instrument should not be more than 5 centimeter. If the distance of instrument is more than 5 centimeter, at the level of the abdominal wall itself, it will start swelling. Then gesture imprecision should be avoided. Like if you have a 10 mm cannula, then avoid 5 mm instrument into that, otherwise it moves like that. This is called as gesture imprecision. Just like if I am sitting on this stool and one of the limb of this stool, one of the leg is small, then it is, this is called as gesture imprecision, it is moving like that. Same way cannula behaves. And after that, if you want to take a suturing and knotting, you will, your telescope, your needle will become unstable. So, that is why it is always better to use the appropriate size of the cannula, or use the long reducer, not the top mounted reducer, because long reducers can decrease the gesture imprecision. Then shadow is beautiful, which you have to use. So, I have a lot of work in the shadow. Laparoscopy, actually the presence of shadow was my invention. It was my thesis topic also, which was finished, my research was finished long back, but it was copyright protected because of 7 instrument companies, they were trying to buy it from my university. And then it was published in Archive of Surgery in 2004, once the university has sold it, this patent technology. So, we can improve the task performance if you will have balanced degree of the shadow and illumination, and then you can have the better performance. So, this was my thesis also, that is optimum shadow casting illumination in laparoscopic, and there are many articles related to that article. This was my first publication, and after that other publication in the shadow was there. So, anyway, many people has worked on the shadow, and if you use the correct shadow, your performance will be good, because your shadow helps you to get a better depth perception. But the contrast of shadow should be only 20%, and that is only possible if you will go at the correct technology of the light source. Now, engineering, minimal access surgery is a byproduct of medical engineering. Basically, laparoscopy is imposed over the surgeons by engineers. Engineers, where they invented telescope, they invented camera, they invented the fiber optic, and they tried to sell it to the doctors, and that way how the laparoscopy started. So, engineering you cannot ignore, you should must learn some of the engineering knowledge. Like when you are attaching the cables behind the monitor, you should know what is the SVDO, what is composite, what is HDMI, what is DVI, what is the R bus, what is the CAN bus, and what are those cables. Generally, we think that this is the job of our nurses, and we do a lot of mistakes because of the improperly connected instrument. Improperly connected, even if you have a stereo system, and if the speaker behind the stereo system is not properly connected, both the speaker is connected into the one channel only, then you are wasting your quality of the sound. So, it is our job, because we have to run, we are the captain of the team. So, all the behind the monitor, these all confidence you should use. Poorly equipment, engineered equipment should be avoided, especially some of the new companies where they mark to marketing a lot, and they will approach you, they will tell you to buy and the things, but generally we should not make ourselves a part of their R&D. So, we should take the instruments from time tested who has a 15 years, 20 years of the experience of selling the instrument. So, in those people if you will buy, then your surgery will be safe. Otherwise, sometime, do you know, once upon a time, Om Surgical, I give you just one example, although it is a good company, but Om Surgical, one of the engineer comes into the mind that why not we are metal cannula, we are putting the powder coating paint over that, because some of the surgeon says that your cannula is very good, but it is giving glare. Whenever I am putting the trocar and cannula inside, it is reflecting the light. So, from their engineers, they came into the mind that in the cannula they started painting with the powder coating. Powder coating is just used in the some of the expensive machine, they are using powder coating. So, the same powder coating he has started using over the cannula, and do you know, there were few of the complication of the burn, and those burns were due to the capacitative coupling, and after that company was in big problem, and few other company, do you know why? Once they make a coating over that, it was eliminating the metal part of the cannula to be contact with the, because it was painted with the powder coating, and metal part of the cannula was not, if any card or any fridge is painted with the thick coating, then you will not get current, because paint is a insulator. So, it was acting as an insulator around the cannula, and it was not allowing the metal part to be in contact with the abdominal wall of the patient, and few of the burn was reported because of capacitative coupling. And then immediately it was reported, actually I was the first person to tell the Mr. Joshi, who is the director of the managing director of the this company, I think I forgot his name. So, and then he has immediately stopped it. I told about the concern. So, this is what happens sometime, the company who are local, I am not saying they are bad, they are very good, they are developing the country, they are doing a good job. But many a time they do not have that much big R&D team as compared to Starge, the Stryker, the Ethicon. So, that is why we should avoid taking the poorly engineered equipment. Then lack of periodical checkup is also one of the problem that we should avoid. We should always try to do the periodical checkup. Every 1 month, every cannula, every insulation, every fiber optic cable, you should make a date. In that date, you should must check it periodically. And faulty power supply, just like right now you have seen the power supply, how it was fluctuating. So, this type of power supply is very bad for expensive instrument, your expensive camera. So, one can burn, especially in India, anytime you never know when it will fluctuate. So, at least 3.5 kVA UPS has to be attached with your entire trolley, so that it will protect your expensive instrument from burning it due to the faulty power supply, or during surgery if power is breakdown, it will give you the backup, because suddenly suppose you are cutting or you are coagulating some artery and suddenly the power is down, then you are in trouble. So, that should must be taken care of. Psychology is also important, because minimal access surgery is often prejudiced. Many a time we are impatient, we are over enthusiastic, we are reluctant to training, and we are dependent to other. Patience is the key. In laparoscopic surgery, whenever your problem has started, you just start doing more slowly. You should not be faster, and you should not lose the patient. Over enthusiastic, we should know when to convert. Sometime patient was not progressing, surgery was not progressing, and you want to do anyhow, then if you are over enthusiastic, you will do complication. Reluctant to training, same mistake if we do 3 times. That means this is not a skill base, this is knowledge base. That means I am doing some of the task analysis wrong, some of the steps I am not following. I am writing A B C D and A L M N O P Q, and in between E F G H I J K is missing, and that missing you have to bring from anywhere, then your this problem will not happen. And how to get it? You try to find your teachers, you try to find out your colleague, you discuss it, that do you know, whenever I am taking the hysterectomy, uterine bleeds, I do not know, or sometime corners of the vagina is bleeding, I do not know why it is happening. Then you will discuss, and they will tell you few of the tips, task analysis. Sir, before do take this, before do go there, before do skeleton line like that, then you will not have a problem, and you will see that problem is solved. Many a time we do not want to ask, because we feel inhibited that what they will say, that he is not knowing, but it is not true. Nobody knows everything in the world, and we should remain hungry, and we should remain foolish. If you are foolish, then you can develop better than if you think that you are the best. So, this is reluctant to training is another drawback. Another is dependent to other. Sometimes we are dependent to our nurses or assistant. Whenever you do, and if camera is not nurse, what is the problem with the camera? This is not. What you have to do, that nurse, you change the shutter of the camera. Nurse, you change the light intensity. Means you yourself know where is your problem. Because you are doctor, your work is to diagnose. So, first you examine yourself, when you are seeing the patient, you are writing the investigation and your provisional diagnosis is already there, and most of the time your provisional diagnosis is correct. Exactly same way, when there is no light, you have to diagnose. If there is no good picture, there may be problem with the light source, there may be problem with the light cable, there will be problem with the aperture, there will be problem with the shutter, there will be problem with the fibroscope filter, there will be problem with the automatic gain control, there is a problem with the red shift, green shift, and I have to correct it by my own. So, dependent to other is a bad habit, because the day you will start becoming dependent to other, your progress will stop and you will become just a technician, you are no more a physician which can diagnose. So, for laparoscopic instrument, you should develop a attitude to do the troubleshooting, that what is wrong and what is troubleshooting, and then you will develop the skill. Then risk factor for iatrogenic injury. Even we do something wrong, there are two type of risk factor. One is patient risk, other is surgeon's risk. Patient risk we cannot avoid. If we are unlucky, we get a wrong patient. Patient has severe obesity, severe adhesion, severe multiple previous surgery or abnormal anatomy. Now, ureter is medial to the suppose uterosacral ligament due to any reason. Now, you are bound to cut it, is not it? Ureter is somehow going to medial to the uterosacral ligament, then there is no way. Sometime right hepatic duct enters into the gallbladder, then who can help you? There is no way, even if you are experienced, you will do the mistake. So, this is the patient risk factor. Another is surgeon's risk factor. Surgeon's risk factor is misinterpretation of anatomy, means what you are seeing is not present. Why? Because of optical illusions. Then inexperience and faulty technique. Your technique is wrong, learning curve. Your technique is correct, but you are a beginners. And learning curve, you are in the initial learning curve. Then misuse of energized instrument. If you get a hammer, everything looks like nail, isn't it? You get a hammer, then everything looks like a nail. You will cut here, cut there. You will give a hammer in a hand of a 5-year-old child, he will break your every equipment of your house. The TV, the fridge, everything is unsafe. Exactly same way, once as a laparoscopic surgeon, you get a sophisticated energy sources like ligature, harmonic. We want to do everything by energy. And once you do it, complication is waiting to happen. An accident is there. So, this also has to be avoided. And some do not have necessary attribute to become a laparoscopic surgeon. It has been published by the Ramsons. Ramsons is a very big scientist who has given these type of study. If you will see here, initially which I have given you the three categories of the human ear, this is Ramsons study. So, according to Ramsons, there is three important, that some do not have necessary attribute to become a laparoscopic surgeon. So, some people what they do, that they are not fit for technical things. Just like if you will see here, some of the Air Force, some they recruit the people. After recruitment, 1 in 100 they send it back. What they do, they try to train them, and after 6 months they give a certificate, a lot of money, and they write a certificate, not technically fit for Air Force job, and they send it back. The reason is they know, they have, because in Air Force there is no any reservation, there is no any consideration, because it is completely unbiased and their law is different. So, they know that this person is technically not fit for Air Force. If you will make this person an Air Force pilot, then he will not kill himself, he will kill others also. So he is not safe for that, because cognitive behavior of some people, especially there is type D personality, those are not good for laparoscopy. They can never become a good laparoscopic surgeon. Fortunately, this batch is very good. It is, no one is like that, but sometime we have some. And do you know, most of those people who are that type of behavior, throughout their life their assistant has performed the surgery and they have assisted their assistant. There are many surgeons in the India and abroad. In every city there is one OT assistant, in every city, and those OT assistants go to different nursing homes, and actually he is performing the surgery. And the surgeons or gynecologists, sometime they become dependent on that OT assistant, and actually he is performing and they assist. So if he will not come, he will not do. Not everyone is doing, but some people who cannot do, they because they have already degree, they have already qualification, but their behavior and their psychology is not appropriate for becoming a surgeon. So some do not have necessary attribute to become a laparoscopic surgeon, but it is very rare. Now first is misinterpretation of anatomy. Surgeons operate on image rather than reality, and visual psychological study has shown that laparoscopic surgery depends upon snapshots, and your success or your disaster depends upon your initial snapshots. What is a snapshot? A snapshot is, suppose I will bring a Salman Khan here, actor, and he will do some exercise, and what all of you are seeing, we do not know. Someone is seeing the six pack abdomen, someone is seeing the fat, someone is seeing the thigh, someone is seeing a very good attractive personality, someone is seeing hair only. And when he will go, and now he will remember about him, what you are remembering only you know. Whenever you will think for him again, what the initial snapshot which you have taken will pop up in your unconscious brain, isn't it? It happens to everyone, every day it is happening to you also. If you see any beautiful thing, which part of that beautiful thing which you have seen depend upon what has attracted you maximum. And when you think about during sleeping or during any time, then what you will see only you knows. Nobody else can tell you that what you are thinking and what is your snapshot. So our brain works on every day thousands of snapshots it is taking from everywhere, and it is keeping storing in the unconscious brain. Exactly same way, once we go by laparoscope to perform surgery, our brain takes snapshots. Someone will take, suppose this is a gallbladder, someone will see CVD, someone will see liver, someone will see duodenum. And if you have a habit of taking the correct snapshots, you will take the Rovier sulcus, you will take the mouth of elephant, you will take the peritoneum, because your way of seeing a snapshot is changed. That's why I told you the brain should be ahead of eye and hand should be behind the eye. So only the brain which knows I can see, and if I can see, then only your hand can operate, otherwise you will operate wrong. So a snapshot should be taken, because in laparoscopy a snapshot is the thing which makes you a good or bad surgeon. And there is a optical illusions, like this picture. What you are seeing in this picture? There is a dog which is eating something, isn't it? Here, or maybe goat, and here this is a dog, or this is what? Mouth. Can you see that?
Yes.
And this is a trunk, this is the upper limb, this is the. Now I will convert this dog into a bull. See here. See that much small, that much small, that much small only. Don't see that much big. Just concentrate in this area. This is head, this is neck, this is upper limb, this is buttock, and there is a bull fighter here. This is a thigh, this is a foot, and he is fighting. No, this is not a bull fighter, this is a crocodile. Now you see that much big. This is the upper jaw. What is there? Yes, this is a jaw. And here is a tree. And this is sad. No, no, nothing is there. There is a face, the girl. Can you see that face? This is the one eye, this is another eye, this is nose, this is mouth. This is a face of a girl. Do you know there are actually 100 pictures incorporated into that? And everyone, if you will try to see it, everyone will get the different snapshots. And once you see one snapshot first time, second time always you will see that first. The people who have seen a goat or dog first, they will not be convinced with a crocodile because of optical illusion. In laparoscopy, there are a lot of optical illusions. These lines are looking parallel or curved. All look curved, but all are parallel. Horizontal lines are also parallel, vertical lines are also parallel. But why it is looking curved? Because of optical illusion. This type of optical illusion creates in the brain because it is a picture. If you see this picture and if you concentrate it, you will see these circles are moving and it is coming out and in. If you see, these are also moving. If you see very carefully, these rings are moving. If you are not seeing moving, you will see it now. See, this is not a video. This is a picture. I am not pressing any mouse to play or to stop. This is a picture. If you see, circle is coming from one eye entering into another eye. Did you see that? And this circle is coming from one eye and entering into the other eye. And that will create you the optical illusion. Exactly same way sometime in laparoscopy, if there is no bleeding also, bleeding looks like. And if there is a glare, sometime we see the glare as a bleeding. And this type of optical illusion is adding because of relative contrast of the picture. If you see, these lines are looking straight, but all the lines are curved. All the lines are curved, which is not straight, but it is looking straight because of optical illusion. Here in this picture, what you are seeing? There is an angel, there is a bat also. The visual psychological people, they use it to identify that which force is governing you. If you see angel first, that means right now you are under the influence of good force. And if you are seeing bat, that means evil force is governing you at present. So, it is evil or good, that depends upon. Exactly same way, if you see, this is bat. This is the face of a bat, this is ear, this is wing, and this is a trunk, and this is angel. Angel is praying, these are wings, and this is a skirt, this is foot, and she is praying, and this is a face. So, exactly same way, if you are doing TLH, if you see angel, you will cut uterine artery. If you see bat, you will cut ureter. And angel and bats are so interweaved, and that happens why your camera person has little bit rotated the CCD or rotated the this thing. Or you try and manipulate it, go a little lateral, you have lost the vision because your initial snapshot was not correct. So, one dissection started, little bleeding started, then your optical illusion comes. And just like in the dark, when you see the hanger, it looks like a ghost. With the hanger with the coat, looks like a ghost, and once you see the ghost, you are afraid. Exactly same way, once the bleeding started, everything gets disinterrupted, you have lost the initial snapshot of the anatomy and you are bound to do the mistake. So, what is the idea? That initially, once you enter into the abdominal cavity, initial 5 minute times, you do not start the surgery, you are not in a hurry. 5 minute times, just you carefully see the snapshots. Just like if you are, suppose you are going in front of this hospital, one criminal come to you, he has robbed you. You go to the police, police will tell you who was that person. You will say, I do not know who was the person, but at the place where he was robbing me, one horse was also standing. One horse was also standing at the place when he was rotting. Now, you will say, horse is still there? No, horse has gone. So, should I search the horse first? They will say, yes. It is useless. Police cannot help you. This is called as relative anatomy. Exactly same way, if you are seeing CBD, no value. Relative anatomy, because it will change with the little traction. That is the meaning of horse. What I have to see? Absolute anatomy. In laparoscopy, a snapshot of absolute anatomy is required. Like, you go to the police, police will ask you, you will tell, no, yes, that person was a little bald, and there was some specs also, wearing the blue shirt and having the pant, and he was little healthy, and he was little less fair, and he was fighting to me. Now, and he was saying that he is a minister also. the son of one minister also, and I remember now his bike was having this number, then police will catch. Exactly same way, whenever your absolute anatomy snapshots you have taken, after that once bleeding started, you don't have problem. You are laughing, you are doing surgery because you are seeing the things nobody else is seeing. That's why when some casualty happens, a massacre happens, to identify the dead body, you are calling the relatives. Because relatives have the snapshot so much in the brain that even if a hand will come, they can recognize, yes, this is mine. Exactly same way, after entering inside the abdomen, you should take a snapshot up to the point of absolute certainty. So that once, because it is not a surgery in reality, laparoscopy is a surgery on image, it is a virtual surgery. Virtual surgery, that's why these things are required. That's why I am speaking these things. In open surgery, it doesn't have any value. And a lot of things depends upon relative anatomy. But in laparoscopy, anatomy and can any time change with a little change in the telescope and camera. Most common bad habit is confident entry and exit, overshooting, intolerance to ignorance of assistant port, less irrigation and suction, ignorance of final inspection, high pressure of pneumoperitoneum and less blunt dissection. I have spoken many times about these things, I don't need to speak it again. But confident entry and exit means you are not seeing the tip of the cannula and your instrument has a habit of going in and out without seeing it. When someone comes to your house, you should must go and receive him, and he go again, go see off, otherwise he will steal something in your house, isn't it? Or it doesn't look good. So whenever a seizure comes, we should go to the tip of the cannula, okay, VIP comes and now you do the job, again you go. If you are busy there and blindly you are bringing your seizures, your aspiration needle, your cannula, one day your patient after 2 days will come with the severe peritonitis. And why it happened? There was a little leak in the cannula, and due to that leak, bubble get plugged into the cannula. You might be seeing in that during the dissection, bubble comes plugged in. This is an abdominal small cavity, so you can see. In the big, we cannot see it. And then one day you will come with the aspiration needle, you have punctured, cannula is dropped, the bubble is dropped, and after 2 days patient comes with the peritonitis. This is very bad. Overshooting, tip of the instrument going beyond the field of the vision, this is also very bad. Ignorance of assistant port. You are performing surgery and assistant is piercing his grasper into the diaphragm or piercing the liver. It is very bad. Less irrigation and suction. Whenever you have lost the anatomy, you start irrigating and sucking. I will tell you, suppose there is a tube ovarian mass, suppose there is a bad endometrioma, suppose there is a bad endometriosis adhesion, suppose there is a severe inflammation of the CVD and gallbladder, and you have lost the anatomy. Just you do one thing, take some saline and keep on irrigating and sucking there, you will get the anatomy clear. Just like in Indian mythology, if you want to make the god happy, you are putting the water and then he is happy. Exactly same way, put the saline on the tissue, tissue will become happy, it will tell you the where to go. Do you know why? People are thinking that you are cleaning something, but actually you are buying time to think about how to go for this surgery. And suction irrigation is a good probe. It gives you little tactile feedback and blunt dissection, and then anatomy will be clear. So wherever you have the problem, start irrigating and sucking. Not only at a time of bleeding, at a time of bleeding anyway you have to do, but other time also when your surgery is not progressing. Then ignorance of final inspection, this is also bad habit. At the end, clockwise complete abdomen cavity should be inspected. You will find out some blood somewhere, you will find out some abnormality, or inferior epigastric is bleeding. Because of cannula pressure, you could not see it at that time. As soon as you check, the cannula bleeding started again. Just like when you are going out of your house, you are checking that your tape of the bathroom is closed or not. Otherwise, come back and your entire house is filled up with the flood. So, final inspection should never be ignored. Then, high pressure of pneumoperitoneum is one other bad habit. Whenever we don't have a vision, we tell increase the pressure, increase the pressure. Remember, after 18, all the complication is quadrupled. What are the complications? You know. Less blunt dissection, this is also a bad habit. Only two place blunt dissection should not be done, either directly the tube serosa or bowel serosa. But elsewhere, suppose bladder is adhered, suppose rectum is adhered, suppose there is a liver, gallbladder is adhered, anywhere, kidney, anywhere you should do the blunt dissection mode. So, this way most common bad habits you can avoid. Now, conversion psychology, there are two type of conversion, one is elective, another is enforced. Elective conversion means you will start the surgery, initial assessment of anatomy, trial dissection for 20 minutes. Within 20 minutes, if surgery is not progressing, if there is a lack of progress, then there is a time to convert. Another is enforced conversion. Enforced conversion means you are not converting, and suddenly the patient will tell, convert me, because some artery is a bulge, like the previous bleeding you have seen, that now there is no way, you have to immediately convert. And whenever you will do enforced conversion, there is increased mortality as well as morbidity. If you will do elective conversion, only minimal increase in morbidity will be there. So, whenever in your mind it comes that I am not happy what I am doing it, convert it. Some people they ask a question, when to convert? Answer is this only. Whenever you think that your surgery is not fruitfully progressing, then it is time to convert. This is called as elective conversion. Normal conversion rate is 1 is to 50. If one patient in 50 you are converting, that means you are good surgeon. If your conversion rate is 1 into 10, 1 into 5, that means you need further training, further skill development. And if you are not converting in 500 also, that means either you are lying or you are very choosy to the patient selection. You do not take the difficult cases, only you take lollipop cases. So, that is why your conversion rate is no there. So, this is conversion, whether it is elective as well as enforced conversion. Fatigue psychology. Laparoscopy is cerebrally 3 times more intensive than open surgery. So, what do you have to do? That cerebrally 3 times more intensive. So, what you have to do? That if you have 5-6 surgery same day, do laparoscopy first. Sometimes what we do reverse. We say, let us finish all the simple surgery and then I will do laparoscopy. This is not good, because once you are tired, your brain is fatigued, then your cognitive behavior will change and your performance will not be good. Another is degradation of eyeball fixation will happen if there is jerky movement, and then your judgment and dexterity will be also affected. Then golden period of laparoscopy is 60 to 90 minutes, minimum 45 minutes. Some people they take 45 minutes golden period, some people they take 90 minutes, and after that strategic rest break. I worked for some time in Imperial College London. I will not tell the name because right now it is recording, but one of the my very favorite consultant, who was my thesis guide also, he was first in the Dundee and after that came to the London, he was Egyptian, still he is a professor and the head of the Imperial College London in the surgery. So, what happens that he was chain smoker, and at that time he was consultant only, he was not head professor, he was not, consultant only. So, he used to smoke during surgery also. I do not know I have told you or not, but this story is true. Now, what he used to do, that suppose he is doing big surgery like esophageal pull through or the gastrectomy or the Roux-en-Y gastric bypass, then after every 1 hour he was leaving the patient and unscrubbing and going to the smoking zone. There was a smoking zone only, you can smoke in that zone only, rest of the hospital is non-smoker. So, he was going immediately running fast to go to the smoking zone, taking 2-3 puffs and then again coming back, again changing and again starting doing surgery. Nurse has complained, she has seen 4, 5, 6 times, and after that she has complained that it is bad, patient is under anesthesia and you are leaving the patient, I will complain it, and she will complain to the dean. The dean has told that now only option what you have, that you have to give the written explanation, and written explanation if you will give, then we can do something. So, written explanation, he has written an explanation and he has quoted many of the literature. If you will see a strategic rest break in rest break in laparoscopy, then many articles are published in which it is allowed that after after every few strategic rest break, the use of a strategic rest break with desufflation of the pneumoperitoneum. So, what is recommended? That suppose you have done the 45 minutes or 90 minutes of the surgery, and now something goes wrong, and or if even it does not go wrong, suppose you have to do the bilateral dermoid or bilateral hernia. You did one hernia, has taken 1 hour time, then you have to take a strategic rest break. How do you do? Deflate the abdomen and sit somewhere, maybe some cold drink, some coffee you can put, and patient is anesthetized. Now you say, why should I use that? Once you deflate the abdomen, cannula will be there. Let the instrument out and abdomen is deflated, all the altered hemodynamics of the patient will get corrected. Like within 90 minutes, when the pneumoperitoneum is there, cardiac output is decreased, renal perfusion is decreased, microatelectasis is started, cerebral artery dilating, hypercarbia build up, small air bubbles are moving somewhere, DVT started. Once you will deflate the abdomen, all these are at least there are 15 things which will be corrected, and now your patient is again able to tolerate the trauma for further 90 minutes and your outcome will be very good. So, I am going for that, I am leaving the patient for 5 minutes to 10 minutes for a strategic rest break, and you are saying that I am going to smoke or I am doing to this, I am doing to that. I will not take a strategic rest break now. From next time, whenever I will operate the patient for 6 hours in one stretch, and if he die, you are responsible. And the head of the department and principal and dean was a skin specialist. He thought that what is this, confused completely. He said, okay, do whatever you want, this is a strategy. So, actually he got an idea from this strategic rest break, that if I have to take a strategic rest break, let us smoke in that strategic rest break, because this is the way how he was making himself fresh. So, some people who can smoke, if you will give them to smoke, now they can work better. So, although it is not good, I am telling you a strategic rest break to take your fatigue factor also decrease, not increase it. So, that is why you have to take a strategic rest break, and that is also very good and it will improve your performance. So, in those situation, it is not like that. Suppose you are doing cholecystectomy and already gallbladder is out, you were just about to remove the gallbladder and it is 60 minutes sting stop, you do not need to do that. What is there? You should further 5 minutes, you should take it out. A strategic rest break is only required if suppose you are already doing the big surgery, you are in the halfway, further half you have to still go, then a strategic rest break is must, like pancreatic surgery, like the colorectal surgery, like the gastrectomy, like the radical hysterectomy, like the very bad ovarian dermoid or these things you can do. Now, operating in DO, this is also fatigue psychology which you have to keep in mind. Suppose you have to do the oesophageal pull through surgery. In oesophageal pull through, there is a laparoscopic part and there is a thoracic part. So, you can take two surgeons together and they can execute their task together. And you know, if the two people they perform the task together, the discipline improves and outcome becomes good, because you want to show your partners your better performance. Do you know, this is a normal attitude, not husband and wife, someone else. So, if it is better, then your performance will improve. In husband and wife, there is a possibility of going down. So, if it is two people they execute together, this becomes a sportsman spirit, this becomes a sportsman spirit, and that way you can operating DO and two surgeons share and execute the procedure, and then it outcome will improve in bigger surgery. So, this is fatigue psychology. Self assessment is very important. You should always define the component steps of the surgery, like you should dream the surgery. If you can dream, then you can perform. Like closing the eye and you are saying, I am doing cholecystectomy, and procedural steps and executional steps, each and every, and I told you minimum 51 executional steps you should be able to write down on the notebook, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 51, and if it is not there, bring it from anywhere, some of the steps you are missing. Another is inter steps, that is procedural, and intra step is executional. Improve your ergonomic as much as possible. Always analyze the video for error identification. Error identification, like sometime what happens that you have done the mistake, you have done the error, and you don't know what mistake you have done. So this is also dangerous. So you should, in open surgery, abdomen is closed, chapter is closed. In laparoscopy, after surgery also you have a teaching. How? You take the video, attach in laptop, take a pen and copy, and your own mistakes, bad traction 3 times, sorting 2 times, overshooting 3 times, bad jerky camera 4 times, more use of energy over smoking 3 times, degradation of eyeball 2 times, sorting, ignorance of assistant entry and exit 5 times, and then give marks to yourself. Never give 10 out of 10. Always try to give less marks so that you can improve. And you know, one of the beautiful thing is, next time when you will do the surgery, if you have already given the marks to yourself in the previous video, next time you will do surgery, same mistake at that point, if you will reach that, immediately your snapshot will come. Oh, in the past video at this time I was sorting, so this time I should not do that, and you will correct it, and every day you will improve. That is why exam has a value. Once you have given an exam any time, even the MBBS, the question which was asked in the entrance exam, still you can remember that question was very bad, I did wrong. So exactly we can learn from our own mistake, and that will how giving the exam. Maintain your instrument yourself, this is very important. Guitarist will never give your guitar to you. A batsman always use the same bats. So sometimes we do not love our instrument, we ignore it. So if you can do maintaining your instrument yourself, make a very big dramatic effect of the instrument what you are using. Otherwise, if you are very busy, then use the same company instrument every time. Don't jump from one to another. If you are used to Ensil and first time you will use Ligasure, you will do the mistake. If you are using one type of instrument, if you will first time you will get another mistake. So have a break after every 45 minutes and keep low threshold of conversion. Keep low threshold of conversion. Conversion is never considered as a failure. Conversion is a part of surgery. Now practice makes the man perfect. A good training institute or your good trainer you should buy, your own endo trainer, and you should try to practice every day. If you will ask any big surgeon, how come you become so good, they will say that I am like that. But they will never tell you the story behind that, that they have many and many hours they have practiced in the endo trainer. Do you know, playing video game also makes the laparoscopic surgeon better. There are many video games which is made for, like Nintendo Wi-Fi, those are recommended. If you will put a video game and laparoscopy, then you will ask many of the, does playing video game improve laparoscopic skill, and impact of video game on training surgeries in the surgeons in the 21st century. Does playing video game, laparoscopic doctor's game, are video game player better in laparoscopic surgery? Do you know why? It has improved your cognitive behavior. That is why if you want to make a community of minimal access surgeon, then the Walsh is showing catch them young. The younger you develop your skill, you will be better in laparoscopy. Exactly same way, if you young people, what they do, they can, your son can play the video game better than you, because his cognitive skill is much better, his brain is sharp and it is completely unbiased. So he will play and he will do tick 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 tick. If same joystick you will take, you will do all the accident. They will say, ma'am, you cannot play, just leave it to me. So it happens same way, but we should develop playing the video game with your son, and your laparoscopic skill will improve. So if you cannot play because you do not want it, then at least you should play on the endo trainers. So just buying the endo trainers is not sufficient, you have to work on the endo trainer. If you can buy the endo trainer, it is good. If you cannot buy the endo trainer, you can make it. If you will go to YouTube and just you type how to make laparoscopic endo trainer, there is a video how to make, there is 1 hour video, laparoscopic endo trainer. Then there are some videos which will tell these are how to make it, how to make it. So you can make a simple cardboard or simple these type of endo trainers, and then you can perform the task and you can improve. Endo trainers are essential to practice it. Do you know? Because suturing and knotting you cannot practice once the patient required, and once the patient doesn't require, I cannot unnecessarily suture. So that's why offline practice is required. If you are seeing any singer who is so fantastic singing, but first he or she has started singing in the bathroom, and then he started singing outside. Otherwise, first time he is not on the stage. So error and disaster is a part of integral part of the human behavior, and in minimal access surgery it is more, but it should be in the LARP region. LARP means as low as reasonably possible, and then trainer should predict what may go wrong, and then you should insert the defect. What go may wrong? For this, in our website we have given you the ability to upload the file. We are getting a lot of uploaded files sometime asking for the steps where was wrong. So in those situation, if suppose you are struggling in the surgery, you can just take a picture of the port which you have made, and you can write it that the size of uterus was this, and you can go to the member area, and in the member area immediately you can upload the file. Once you will upload the file, this file comes to us, and after that this is a minimally invasive safety checklist. You will see each and every this dot you have to click, and you, this is by SAGES. This checklist has been developed to operating room, so that your performance will improve, and this is add-on. So this is important. If you want to go to the share your file, you will go to the share your file. Suppose you have done the surgery and your ports are wrong, or you have struggled during the port, your elevation angle was wrong, then you should never hesitate, just put your name, put your email, and just choose the file and you have already taken, and collect the file and start uploading. And your question, next day you go to the download, your answer is, you will get it there. So this way the training should not be stopped here. This is our just the beginning of the relationship. This is not your end, and this is your institute. Anytime later if you want any help online, we are always open to help you, so that we can predict what may go wrong, and then we can insert the defense system, so that next time the same complication will not happen to you. So mistakes are very important. We have to do the mistake one time or another. One cannot expect to perform surgery without encountering some type of adverse situation, because in this profession you cannot always do without any mistake anywhere, but it should be in the LARP region. LARP region means as low as reasonably possible, and after that you can put a defense system, so that it should be a tip of an iceberg. It should not be sinking of the entire ship, and then your mistake will be less. So, those who were sleeping can open their eyes now. Thank you very much.